A very good morning to our fellow classmates and Mr. Ong. We are here to present our slides for Chapter 6 of Social Studies, which is Cooperating Together Through ASEAN. These are our team members, Baika, Unsing, Dian, Lanling, Brunel, and Giselle, and I'm the team leader. Now I pass my time to Lanling to tell you more about ASEAN.
ASEAN is an important regional organization in Southeast Asia. ASEAN brings together Southeast Asian countries with diverse groups of people and cultures. It is an association that aims to promote peace and stability in the region. It was formed on 8th of August 1967 by Indonesia, Malaysia, the Philippines, Singapore, and Thailand.
Since then, membership has expanded to include Brunei, Cambodia, Laos, Myanmar, and Vietnam. Its aims include accelerating economic growth, social progress, and social-cultural evolution among its members, alongside protection of regional stability and opportunities for member countries to resolve differences peacefully.
Against the backdrop of the Cold War and the arbitrary transition to independence occurring in many Southeast Asian states, such a commitment was of great importance for building trust in a region divided by stark differences of ethnicity. And the first history of interstate cooperation during the period of colonization. In 1967, Thailand's foreign minister, Thanom Komorn, suggested setting up a new organization. The five founding fathers are Francisco R. Ramos from the Philippines, Adam Malik from Indonesia, S. Rajaratnam from Singapore, Tun Abdul Razak from Malaysia, and Thanom Komorn from Thailand.
The expansion of ASEAN from 1967 to 1999 is according to the timeline shown in the slide. This is the ASEAN logo. The white represents purity, while the yellow represents prosperity. Red represents courage and dynamism, and the circle represents a united ASEAN.
The 10 stalks of paddy in the center represent the dream of the founding fathers of an ASEAN made out of all countries in Southeast Asia, bonding together in friendship and unity. Blue represents peace and stability. Now let's watch a video based on how the ASEAN community was formed.
Singapore, Thailand, ASEAN community is a place where all the 10 countries come together to build a better life for everyone. Together as 10, we are stronger and can do more than one country alone. But to get there, we first have to walk through these three doors. Each door will show us a different part of the road that will take us to the ASEAN community. Let's see what's behind each door. This is the door of peace. We need all 10 countries to work together to keep the region safe. We won't let terrorists, pirates, and drugs come to ruin our countries. ASEAN countries don't fight one another. And we all live in peace. And where there is peace, we can have prosperity. We can enjoy the good things that come with stronger economic development. As we attract more investors, businesses will grow, and there will be more jobs and opportunities. And one day, you may be able to work in any ASEAN country of your choice. Whether you are an engineer, a businesswoman, or a nurse. Outside the cities, agriculture will also become more advanced. Our farmers will benefit, and so will we. Our quality of life will improve. We will have better roads and transport systems. Access to high-tech innovation. And be connected to the world. And as good neighbors, we will also help one another prosper. But peace and prosperity aren't the only part of the ASEAN community. Do you know what is the most important part?
People!
Absolutely. ASEAN governments work hard to ensure that people can enjoy a better life. And can you guess how ASEAN countries do that? By keeping our environment clean and green. Helping one another with disaster strike. Working together to fight nasty diseases. Finding ways for our people to learn about one another. Learn from each other. And finding ways to keep our family strong.
Are we too young to be part of this ASEAN community?
You're never too young. You can start with some simple thing. Make friends with young people from other ASEAN countries. And learn another ASEAN language if you can. Find out more about the region's history. Most of all, be proud of your identity as an ASEAN citizen. And look forward to what the future holds. So, are you ready to be part of the ASEAN community?
From reduced production costs. However, the reduced tariffs have negatively impacted Thailand's agriculture sector due to a greater number of imported agriculture goods.
As of 2014, Cambodia, a developing member of ASEAN, is not yet ready for economic integration even as the 2015 deadline for streamlining its tariffs approaches. The ASEAN economic community has faced criticism for not protecting small and medium enterprises and for being reluctant to promote human rights and democracy in countries such as Myanmar.
Now, I want to talk about ASEAN is to promote peace and stability in and between the region and the world to create a stable, prosperous and highly competitive ASEAN economic region and to promote a community of caring societies so as to improve the lives of people in ASEAN. Now, we are going to tell you about the different types of costume for some countries. First up is the national costume for Brunei. The costume for male is the Baju Melayu. It is traditionally worn with a plaid or foreign pattern sari called Simjang, which extends from the waist to the knees. Although the designs of such garments vary in local social status, contemporary Brunei tends to be less aware of these symbolic.
Next, Miss Cambodia. The color of costumes is different from Monday to Sunday as follows: light yellow, green, gray, blue, dark green, and red. Clothing in Cambodia is one of the most important aspects of the culture. Cambodian fashion is divided by the people's differing castes and social classes. Cambodians traditionally wear the checkered scarf called the krama. The krama is what distinctly separates the Cambodians from their neighbors, the Thai, the Vietnamese, and the Laotians. The scarf is used for many purposes, including for style, protection from the sun, an aid for your feet while climbing trees, a hammock for infants, a towel, or as a sarong. A krama can also be easily shaped into a small child's doll for play. Under the Cambodian rug, krama of various patterns were part of standard clothing. Next is the costume for Laos. Each gender wears different types of clothing. According to the Laos beliefs and values, women are considered as mothers of the nation, so Laos women need to dress up well. They usually wear the scarves, blouses and a silk skirt and coil their hair when they attend important ceremonies. The traditional costumes for women in Laos mostly include a sin, a blouse or super.
IT skills and English language. Second, economic cooperation and assistance. Singapore offered 80 million to developing countries from year 2000 to 2003 as aid package under the initiative of ASEAN Integration Initiative. Next, we will be talking about the aims, purposes, and functions of ASEAN community. First, to accelerate the economic growth, social progress, and cultural development in the region through joint endeavors in the spirit of equality and partnership in order to strengthen the foundation of prosperous and peaceful community of Southeast Asia. Second, to promote active collaboration and mutual assistance on matters of common interest in the economy, social, cultural, pandemic, scientific, and atmospheric fields. Third, to collaborate more efficiently for the greater utensil of their agriculture and industry, the expansion of their trade include the study of the problems of international community trade, the improvement of their transportation and communication facilities, and the rising of living standards of their peoples.
Now, I will be talking about the ways ASEAN community serves as a platform to bring out peace, unity, and prosperity. The ASEAN community is comprised of three pillars: the political security community, economic community, and the social cultural community. Singapore strongly supports ASEAN's goal of building a strong, cohesive, and prosperous ASEAN. Also, ASEAN as a concert of Southeast Asian nations, outward looking in peace, stability, and prosperity, bonded together in partnership in dynamic development and in a community of caring societies.
Working together to manage disasters, such as extending help to neighbors who need it, is also an important part of building the ASEAN community. ASEAN countries conduct joint simulation exercises to familiarize with one another's emergency operations to be prepared.
In Malaysia on September 2005, the first ever ASEAN regional disaster emergency response exercise was based on the earthquake scenario held in Singapore. This helped ASEAN to respond swiftly when an actual earthquake struck in Malaysia in May 2006. It killed 5,000 people and caused massive destruction in Yogyakarta and Central Java.
They also distributed relief packages which contained food and medical supplies and carried out medical outreach to the local community. the ASEAN is working together is to strengthen food security. This means that the people in the region have access to enough food at all times. Food security became a very serious concern when international food prices increased sharply in 2007 and 2008. Millions in ASEAN were affected as the prices of essential items such as cooking oil and rice kept increasing. As a result, the ASEAN Food Security Program was started in 2008 to ensure there is long-term food security in the region.
Thank you.